Hi there. Pulling networks between two buildings is not that difficult, but sometimes it could be a challenge while the distance is beyond 328 feet. Today we received a case from one of our customers, and here's the scenario. Our customer wants to set up a network link between those two buildings. The distance is about 450 feet. He can't pull the continuous run network cable because the network signal will start dropping after 328 feet. Moreover, the power source is not present at the middle, so adding a network switch to repeat the network is not an ideal option. And today in this video, I'm going to show you two different ways to pull the network between the two buildings. And if you need help with your system design, please follow the link in the description below. And it will be best if you send us the diagram map, or even some simple drawing. So the first method is to use a Cat 6 UTP cable. Adding a new switch is not a great idea, not only because there's no power available between the buildings, but also the latency. The switching process will increase the latency of data transmission. So we decide to use a PoE extender. A PoE extender can repeat the PoE network. Now, this is a 1 GB PoE extender. Put it in the middle, can repeat another 328 feet. And it doesn't require any external power because the PoE extender can take the power in line. Now, let's connect it together. So let's do a quick connection using the PoE extender to connect both cables, suppose two buildings. Those are 328 feet cable. Let's begin with the first building. Suppose this is the first building, we have the modem. The modem is already powered up. And since this is a PoE, non-PoE device, that's why we need the PoE injector. And let's take a look. For the PoE injector, we have two ports. This is the data port. We are going to use it to connect to the main network. Just plug it in. And for the PoE port, we can just connect the cable from the first building. Yes. And plug it in. And make sure you plug in the AC power port. And the injector will convert the AC power into the DC low voltage power, so don't worry. Now the power light is on. This side we are set. Let's move over to the PoE extender. On this end of the cable, we are going to put the cable into the PoE extender. To save time, I already pull it through the neck and the gland. Now we just have to plug it in here. And you can see the light is on. We have to fasten this side. And for the PoE out port, we are going to connect the port to the cable from the second building. Now to save time, I also already pull it through. And let's connect in. All right. And make sure you use the wrench to fasten all your neck and your gland because it will have a great waterproof result. And for this extra port, we use a rubber button to seal it up so that no water can get in. Okay, let's move over here. At the end of the cable, we are going to plug it into the modem. And let's see, the lights is on. And all the indicators lights are on. It's already working now. See, it's really simple and easy setup. And do we need any device on the second building? No, we don't. And since the PoE extender will verify and classify the edge device, if your edge device is also PoE, non-PoE device, the PoE extender will just send the data but not the power. So it's pretty easy, right? So the second method is to use the fiber optic cable. The fiber optic cable can provide long distance. The maximum distance by using a single mode fiber optic cable from point A to point B can up to 80 kilometers. So distance won't be an issue anymore if you choose to use a fiber optic cable. However, we cannot connect the fiber optic cable directly to the router. So let's take a look what we need today. First, of course, we need the fiber optic cable. This cable is already pre-made, so we don't have to worry about the connector. And it's also 100% tested in the factory. The pulling eyes comes with both ends, so it's pretty handy. And this is a single mode fiber optic cable with an LC connector. Now, next we need the media converter. The media converter can convert electronic signal to optical cable signal. And also, we need the SFP transceivers. The SFP transceivers typically sold separately because we need to determine what kind of fiber optic cable you use or what kind of connector you use. Now, let's connect everything together. All right, so let's pretend this is the first building. The router is already powered up and it's on. And make sure you plug in the power port for the media converter because it needs power to run. Now it's in, the light is on. And let's connect the cable from the main network. In. And over this side, we put the SFP transceiver in here. And we only have to pick one cord, so let's pick A. All right, it's already in, so it's pretty easy. Now, let's move over to this side and do the same thing. And this is the second building. So again, the SFP transceiver in, and make sure you take the right one. We took A, so now A in here. All right. And make sure you put the cable and also the power. Just exactly the same thing. The indicator lights are on. Now we are all set to go. So the whole setup is pretty easy, right? So some of you may wonder why we only use a single string to link two media converter, because today we use the BD transceiver. The BD transceiver has a different wavelength to transmit and receive data. So we get an unused fiber optic string we can use in the future. Now, if you want to learn more about how to pick an SFP transceiver, you can click to another video to watch it. Now, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.